Hello traders, this is McBillion. Today is December 29, 2016, and let's talk about the market. Let's start with the S&P mini futures, and I'm going to show you what happened in 2016. As you can see here, in January, between January and February, we moved sideways, and it was perfect for day trades or short-term trades, you know, 1, 2 days, 3 days maximum. Then we break out at the end of February, and it was this part here, it was really good for swing trades, but only lasts a month or 2 months. Then between March and July, we move sideways again, really bad for swing trades, good for day trades. Then again, we break out here, but it lasts only a couple days, and then we move sideways between July and November. Now, if you were brave enough to trade the election and you watch my last video, which is next right here next to your right, you would think that the market was gonna break down, like many people would say. The media was saying that the market was gonna go to hell. It didn't happen. It break out, and this part right here, it was really good for swing trades and also day trades or whatever if you went with the bulls. Right here, we have a nice rally, and now it's just moving sideways, waiting for the end of the year, which is going to happen in 2 days. So now, what is going to happen this year? I'm predicting that 2017 is going to be a really good year for swing trades, and I'm going to get prepared for this 2017 because I'm going to trade this year very hard, and I'm going to do a lot of swing trades. If you haven't subscribed to my website, please do. I will have a lot of good trades for swing trades and long-term trades. So now let's talk about one of the best stocks that I'm watching, Apple right here. So this is an excellent idea. If you can see, you have an Apple that was trending down, making lower lows, but then it stopped right here, Fibonacci 91.71, and it started moving inside a channel. This is a channel right here. With resisting at 118, that's the resistance. We have been there back in October, but we fell right here and went down to 104. Now we are right here resisting or near resisting, and we wanna see if we're gonna break out right here. So what is the difference between this and October and now at the end of the year? Well, back in October, you have ADX was at 24, 25, now it's the same 24, it's a strong bull, but right now we're trending up. This is a trend right here, and this is the second retest. We might retest 113 again, but I think we finally gonna break out here and retest the major resistance, which was test back in 2015, February, April, and July. So I think we're gonna go to 133. There is not resistant right here if we break out 119. So write it down. The key level is 119. If you see the stop holding about 119, you can use that same level for a stop loss because we can get a nice move from here. Now let's talk about another one. Let's talk about Amazon. So this is a 5-year chart, and you can see Amazon is a very strong stock, has been trending up, making higher highs and higher lows. And you can see here, it's just trending inside of this wedge, a triangle, symmetrical triangle wedge. And DMI is bearish, but ADX is very low. So what does that mean, ADX very low? So when ADX goes so low, which is this yellow line right here, let me show you, this is so low, it's telling you that there is a lot of shares being traded, but from people that trade small, not big money. When ADX is high, it means that there is a lot of people trading the stock, and it's big money. The cowboys, the guys that move the stock market, the money market makers. But right now, it's just not appetite for the big guys. So that's what it means. But it's also an indicator that it might get the attention to the big guys, and we might get a big move, and it's showing it right here, this sideways move. It's going to either break out or it's going to break down. Now, so let's trade smart and wait for the breakout. Let's not be biased and say, you know, I don't like it or whatever. You know, let's wait for the breakout of 70.78 or 70.79 or below 7.55. If we break down below the 7.55, I think it's going to retest the 6.48. Now, the trend is down because it's making, you know, it went down and then moved sideways. So it looks like it, you know, the trend is down. So there is a higher probability that it's still going to break down. Let's say a 60% here, 40% here. That it's going to continue moving sideways? I don't think so, because as I say, ADS being so low is going to call attention to the big guys very soon. So keep an eye on Amazon, because we can get a nice swing trade from here. Now let's talk about APA. I use APA to trade oil. You can see here is moving inside this uptrend channel. Resisting is at 67.85, and it's right at the middle of the chart. So what do you do here? Nothing. You just wait. You just wait until it's at the bottom or it's at the top. So put it in your watch list. So now let's talk about Facebook. Facebook was making higher lows. You can see here, higher lows. Every time it goes down, people buy it. Now it's a support 113. That's the key level. If you break down 113, it's going to go to 104.100. Right now, it break down this uptrend channel, and it's moving sideways at 113. So right here, what you need to know is the ADX is high. So there's a lot of money, but ADX is bearish. So I think there is a 70% probability that we're going to break down and test this area, 104, and that's my area to go long and watch it as a stop loss. You know, if you go long right here, 104, and break down 104, get out. That's simple. Why? Because it's a strong stock and there is a strong bull market. We're going to continue higher. Maybe short term we're gonna do some dips and people are gonna buy those dips. Believe me. Now let's talk about another one. Let's talk about IWM. Let me show you the Russell. The Russell is very strong. Higher lows. Moving sideways here at the end of the year. Fibonacci 138.38 and 133.33. 77. So if you break out right here, it's gonna continue very nicely. If you break down, probably going to retest the 126, but it's going to, a lot of people are waiting to see if they can get it right here again, because it was major resistance, so this is going to be major support. So there's a lot of people with their fingers in the trigger to buy it right here, and we hope we can buy it right here. But if I see a breakout right here, I'm sure it's going to go to 145 easily before it goes down. Now let's talk about another one. Let's talk about Netflix. Netflix is another very strong stock that is making higher lows. You see higher lows. And it's retesting major resistance Fibonacci 126. 126 was resistant back in August 2015 and December 2015. It was resisting in October, and right now we're trending right at the top. So what are you waiting here? So you want to see a trend. You want to see a breakout and a confirmation, because every time it break out right here, the next day it didn't confirm, but it only confirmed for a few minutes and then trend down. Right here, the same. The next day, it tried to confirm, it failed. So right here, today, it tried to confirm and it failed. So let's see what happens tomorrow, end of the year, or what happened at the beginning of the year. If you're going to break out, or if you're going to break down and test this trend line right here. Now let's talk about another one. Let's talk about the spider. So the spider right here, as you can see here, is very strong, and that's what I'm telling you, that the market is strong. The market is not weak. Don't put attention to the media. The market is very strong, and it's going to continue strong. Trade price. Trade what you see in your charts. So right here, you can see the trend line making higher lows, and you can see the Fibonacci 223 being support. There's a very small candle today, meaning people don't know what to do. They're waiting for the end of the year to jump in. So maybe we can get right here. If we get right here, I'm going to go long really nicely, because this is going to just go right here and boom, it's going to go and make higher highs, probably 230, 240, or 250. So let's see what happens. And it's between those two Fibonacci, 226, 223. So let's see what happens. And I'm gonna see how we trace at the beginning of the year to make a decision to enter the spider or other that I have on my watch list. So please, traders, follow me on YouTube so you can get these videos right away when I post it. And if you want, subscribe to my website, or you can subscribe to my newsletter. So this is everything for today. Happy New Year, and trade off.